Hello everyone, Zimzim here, welcome back to Let's Play Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition. Last time, we played as Lana.
He had heard tell of a land in the clouds, but now he could see Skylight with his own eyes, though he was not the first new arrival. Overrun with monsters, the floating island faced imminent destruction. Though vastly outnumbered, Link did not hesitate. He and his allies leapt into the fray to save Skyloft from disaster.
Yep, and we're going to be using a new fighting style, the spinner. Or, as I like to call it... Okay, go away. Sorry. This... The Beyblade! Beyblade, Beyblade, let her rip! Beyblade, Beyblade, let her rip! Let's fight an epic battle, face off, and spin the metal! No time for doubt now, no place for backing down! Beyblade, Beyblade, let her rip! Beyblade, Beyblade, let her... Okay, I'll stop. I'm sorry. I just knew Beyblade from my childhood, and... For some reason, I knew that much of the song, and I don't know why. But now, we see a new character. Before we can talk about the spinner more. Fie. You're not the master, but I can sue a master. Personal space, fire. Soup! Anyways, the spinner's crowd control and it's actually really fun. The only sad thing is that you're not really going to be using these other spinners you start placing down. This has relevance in Skyward Sword. Sorry, I just love how seamless everything is. It brings out the best of the spinner. And wait until this happens every single time. Even on replays, you have to wait.
Ghirahim. Too bad that you have to deal with something you've never dealt with before. A man on the Beyblade. Can't stop me. This is not a drill. Repeat, it's not a drill. And of course, the best character, the best villain, probably best character, honestly, in Zelda, disappears from this map completely. Beep. Bam. Boom! Fi, really? Ignore them, Fi. They're not a threat. Granted, those moblet flanks are going to be very helpful. I need to get up there. We need to go up here anyways, so them appearing now was actually not that bad. No more saboteurs. Like, the enemy is still moving. It's not fun. Oh my god. And the mainland got... going back here because the enemy got further than I thought, because they usually don't manage to actually capture that keep unless I'm playing Hero, because yes, I do play on Hero on Legends, but haven't played it on this version. forgot about this. That's one chieftain down. I don't know why they decided to blow up both ends. I don't get it personally. Still not open. Now they're all heading toward the base. Don't need to. No, I hate when the game is like, oh yeah, you can lock onto this foe, and then locks onto someone else. Really? Really? Again? And Volga's become stronger. There was no great fairy here in Skyloft. Fairy fountain is open. And now we can use this. Yes. This is dumb. Now let's go take down a dragon. Let's go take down a dragon. A Durgan. A Volvagia. It's not enough. You should do more. I'm just gonna smack him about. Getting weak again. He's jumping again. Smack. Oh, I thought for some reason there was suddenly more. How drab. It should bring this little moment to an end. Make things a bit more tolerable. No, on second thought. It might be more fun to destroy them from the inside. And now... parkour. Yep. And that'll be it for this episode. Quite short. Then again, these episodes were going to be made shorter since now I'm not playing on Hero. Which I'm still a bit sad that I'm not going to, but hey. Next time is... no! The infamous Water Temple! And being real, it's not that bad. Even in Ocarina of Time, it's just tedious. It's not awful. Unlike the Temple of the Ocean... the Temple of the Ocean King. I definitely felt some people wince at that. I did too. Don't worry. But that's for next time. I'll see you guys then. Xenu Zimmer signing out. And yes, I may have almost knocked over my mic.